हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू केयर लकम सीबीएसई स्कूल मुदौड़ ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड प्रॉब्लम्स इन एक्सरसाइज 1.1। सो आई डिस्कस सम ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 1.1। सपोज इफ यू हैव डाउट्स रिलेटेड टू दैट एक्सरसाइज 1.1, यू कैन व्हाट्सएप मी, सो दैट डेफिनेटली आई विल मेक वन वीडियो ऑन योर डाउट्स। इफ एनी डाउट्स ऑन एनी प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 1.1, so I will try to make video on that to solve your doubts. So today I will continue with the next concept, that is properties of addition and subtraction of integer. Properties of addition and subtraction of integers. So we'll see different properties of addition and subtraction of integers. So now first we'll start with the closure property. I hope you all remember this property, closure under addition. Closure under addition. Already you check the closure property for whole numbers in previous class. Okay, so now we will check this closure property for integers, that too for addition. Closure means what? So if you use here two integers to add, when you are using two integers to add, if the result or if the answer is also integer number, then we can say that is closed under addition. We can say that closed under addition. Or here I will consider two numbers, any two integers you can consider. For example, 17 plus 14 in textbook they have given that. 17 plus 14 means what you will get? They are given 17 plus 24, but here I have written 17 plus 14. You can consider this also. So 17 plus 14 means you will get 31. So you can see here, this 17 is also integer and 14 is also integer. When you add these two integers, again you are getting integer only, that is 31. Okay? These two are positive integer, again we are getting integer only. So we can say that closed under addition. So again I will consider one more example. 25 plus we are adding minus 5. So 25 plus into bracket minus 5 I have written. You can see here this 25 is positive integer and minus 5 is also negative integer. These two are integers only, but this one is positive integer and this one is negative integer. So when you are adding here 25, I will write it as it is only. First 25 I have written as it is. Next, after this here plus into minus, minus, so minus 5. So 25 minus 5 means what you will get? 20. So now you can see here this 20 is also integer. So when you are adding two integers here, as a result what you are getting? Integer number only. Therefore here they are given integers are closed under addition. Therefore I will write here integers are closed under addition. Integers are closed under addition. Now we'll see with subtraction, closure under subtraction. So just watch this video and write this, and do one thing while writing, write some more example. Here I have written two examples, write at least another five examples for this, for closure under addition. Now we'll see example for, we'll check closure property for subtraction. to write these things, just pause this video and you can write. Closure under subtraction. So here I will consider any two integers again. For example, 7 minus 9. I am subtracting here 7 minus 9. So what is the answer we will get? Get means plus into minus minus, we are subtracting. So 9 minus 7 means what you get? 2. And the sign in front of bigger value is minus here. Therefore, we will get minus 2 here. Okay? So here you can see this 7 is positive integer and this 9 is also integer, and here answer what we got? Minus 2. This is also integer only. We will check with another example, that is 17. We will subtract minus 21. 17 minus, we are subtracting how much? Minus 21 here. So we considered again two integers, that is 17 and minus 21. So let us see what we will get. 17 I will write it as it is only, and here minus into minus plus 21. To get it outside the bracket, we will multiply minus here. So minus into minus plus 21, I will write it as it is. Now 17 plus 21 means what you will get? 38. So you can see here answer what we got? 38. This is also integer only. Like that, if you consider any values here to subtract, answer what you will get? Integer only. So that we can say that integers are closed under subtraction. Therefore, here I will write integers are closed under subtraction. Okay, here remember this, for closure property of integers, closed under addition and closed under subtraction also. What is the meaning of this closure property? When you add two integers or when you subtract two integers, answer should be integer only. So here when you are adding two integers, you are getting integer only, and when you are subtracting two integers, you are getting integer only. Therefore, integers are closed under addition and integers are closed under subtraction. Okay, remember this property, and remember this, these two are closed under addition and subtraction. So let us see next property. And one more thing, while writing this, write some more examples. Already they have given here in textbook. Solve those problems and write the answers while writing this. I have given two examples. Write at least minimum 5 examples for this closure under subtraction. So now we will discuss next property, that is commutative property. Commutative property. So what it means, commutative property means, here A plus B should be equals to B plus A. In reverse order also, we should get same answer. Therefore, first we will check this commutative property for addition. So now we will try to add two integer values. So here I will consider 5 and minus 6 as two integers. So here if I consider a value as 5 plus into bracket minus 6 as b value. I will check whether these two are equal or not. 5 plus minus 6 and minus 6 plus 5. Okay? Whether these two are equal or not, we will check this. So 5 plus minus 6 means what we will get? Plus into minus, minus. Therefore, 5 plus into minus, minus. We will write 6 here. 5 minus 6 means what we will get? Plus into minus, minus. Therefore, we have to subtract. 6 minus 5, 1. And the sign in front of bigger value is minus. Therefore, we will get minus 1 here. Now we will consider this minus 6 plus 5. Minus 6 plus 5. So directly we can calculate here minus into plus minus. Therefore we have to subtract. 6 minus 5, what you get? 1. And the sign in front of bigger value is minus. Therefore again here also we got minus 1. When you interchange these terms, 5 minus 6, here we got minus 6, 5. When we interchange these two terms A and B, we are getting same answers. That is minus 1 only here. Therefore, we can write it as A plus B equals to B plus A. So that we can say that addition is commutative for integer. Therefore, I will write, therefore addition is commutative for integers, because we are getting same answer here. This is for addition. Like this only, try to consider some other examples they have given in textbook. You can consider those values also. Consider those values and give some two or three examples for this property. Commutativity property for addition. What is this property? A plus B equals to B plus A. Means if you consider A and B values, when you interchange these two values, you will get same answer for addition. So that consider those examples given in textbook and give some two or three examples for this property also. Okay, now write this, and now we will see this commutative property for subtraction. For subtraction we will see. So we will consider two integers as 5 and minus 3. In textbook they are given two integers, 5 and minus 3. Consider two integers, 5 and minus 3. And we are checking this for subtraction of commutativity. Means A minus B and B minus A. So now we will check with A minus B. So 5 minus, what is B value? Minus 3. So let us see what we will get. 5, I will write it as it is only. Minus into minus plus 3. So 5 plus 3 means what we will get? 8. Okay, now we will interchange these two values and we will check what is the value we will get. So here first I will write B value, that is minus 3, and next minus, we are subtracting 5. So minus 3 minus 5 means what we will get means minus into minus plus. Therefore we have to add 3 plus 5, what we will get? 8. So 8, and the sign in front of bigger value is minus here. Therefore minus 8. You can see here you got plus 8, but here we are getting minus 8. But here these two answers are different.
Therefore, we say that subtraction is not commutative for integers because we are getting different values here. Therefore, here I will write, therefore, subtraction is not commutative for integers. Okay, remember this commutative property means when you consider two values A and B, you should get same answer when you interchange also. For addition, that is A plus B equals to B plus A. Okay, when you considered that example, you got same answers when you interchange A and B values. But here for subtraction, you can see we are getting different answers. A minus B is not equals to B minus A. Therefore, subtraction is not commutative for integers. Okay, this is about commutative property. Now we'll see about associative property. Write this example, just pause the video and write. And while writing, just consider another two examples. Consider any random two integer values and just you have to subtract again. Okay, write some one or two examples for this. So now I will discuss last one, that is associative property. So for this associative property, we want three integers. So let us consider three integers here. They are given minus 3, minus 2 and minus 5. So here I will write, consider for this property, we want three integers. Consider three integers minus 3, minus 2, minus 5. Okay, so now what we will do, we will make two groups here for addition. This is for addition. So right here, this is for addition, or here we are checking this property with addition only, because for subtraction only we are getting different answers in commutative property. Then here in associative property also you will get definitely different answers. So no need to check for subtraction. Directly we will check this for addition only. Okay. So now I will make two groups here. So first I will calculate here. First I will consider this minus 5. First plus into bracket minus 3. Plus minus 2. Okay, we will calculate this. What we will get, we will check. Okay, so here minus 5 I will write it as it is only, and here plus into minus, or first we will solve this. Inside this square bracket we have minus 3, minus 2. So we will solve that first. So minus 3 I will write it as it is, plus into minus, minus. Therefore minus 2 I will write here. Minus 3, minus 2 we will get. So now here minus 5 plus into bracket minus 3 minus 2 means what you will get, means minus into minus plus. So 3 plus 2, 5, and the sign in front of bigger value is minus. Therefore we will get minus 5. When we calculated this, we got answer as minus 5. So now here minus 5 plus into minus, minus 5. Plus into minus, inside bracket we have minus. Therefore plus into minus, minus 5 I have written as it is only. Now we got minus 5 and minus 5. So what we get, minus 5 minus 5 means? So here minus into minus plus, you have to add. So 5 plus 5, 10, and the sign in front of bigger value is minus. Therefore, we got minus 10. Now let us check with minus 5, minus 3. We will make this group separately, and we will consider minus 2 separately. So here I will make group like this. Here you can see minus 5. I have not considered in one group separately. I have written, and in this square box I have considered minus 3 and minus 2. Now what I will do? I will consider minus 5, minus 3 in one square box, and I will write minus 2 outside the square box. Okay? So first I will write this minus 5 plus what we have here, minus 3. I have written first two terms inside the square box, but here you can see I have written last two terms in square box. Okay? So now we will check whether we will get same answer or not. Plus minus 2 I will write outside the bracket, outside the square box. Okay? So now here minus 5 minus 3, we will calculate this first. So inside square bracket, minus 5 plus first I will write plus into minus, minus 3, and I will complete this bracket. Here plus into minus, minus 2. Here minus 5 minus 3 means what we will get? Minus into minus plus. Therefore we have to add 5 plus 3, 8, and the sign in front of bigger value is minus. Therefore minus 8 minus 2 we will get. Minus 8 minus 2 means, you can see here, minus 8 minus 2 means minus into minus plus. So 8 plus 2 means we will get 10, and the sign in front of bigger value is minus. Here again we will get minus 10 only. You can see here also we got minus 10, and here also we got minus 10 only. In both cases we are getting same answer. What is the difference? Here we have considered minus 5 outside the group, and minus 3 minus 2 inside the one group. Here we considered this minus 5 minus 3 inside one bracket, and minus 2 outside that square bracket. Then also we are getting same answer. And you may have another doubt here. Instead of writing this minus 3 minus 2 first, I have written minus 5 first here. After that I have written minus 3 minus 2. Okay? So no need to write minus 5 only first. You can write minus 3 also first. Minus 3 minus 2 consider it as first, and minus 5 you can consider it as last term also. But the only the thing is, first you have to make two terms as a group, and again what you will do? Again you have to consider another two terms as one group. Okay? Like that you have to consider, so that we will get same answer only. So that we can say here, this a plus b, a plus into bracket b plus c, for next two terms we are taking bracket here. This is equal to, therefore here we are taking bracket for first two terms. So here I will write a plus b, these two in one bracket, a plus b plus c outside the bracket, plus c. This is the commutative property. A plus into bracket b plus c equals to a plus b plus c. Okay? And here you can write that. Below that what you can write? Addition is associative for integers. Below this write. Therefore, addition is associative for integers. Okay? And no need to check for subtraction, because commutative is not applicable, means will not, this is not applicable to subtraction. Okay? Just pause this video and write this. After writing this, they have given some more examples in textbook that is not completely solved, and try to solve those examples. While writing this, just give another 2 or 3 examples. Okay? In next class I will continue with additive identity, and I will give some more examples related to additive identity and these properties, and if possible I will start exercise 1.2. Okay? Thank you all.